Goldman Island!
A packed O'Neill's in Port Richmond, just overflowing with love for the Mid-Island team that has captured the hearts of all New Yorkers. The Mid-Island All-Star 12s hasn't lost a game in 2 years, and parents who know the boys say it's all because they've been playing together for so many years.
Just watching them play, how they handle themselves, and how they're going forward. They're just making Staten Island proud.
I think it's just the way they united all of Staten Island, that all of Staten Island is so excited to see them do this well and make it this far in the World Series so far.
Everyone here at O'Neill's was confident going into the game as these Staten Island mostly 7th and 8th graders took on Honolulu, the only two undefeated clubs remaining. But sadly for Mid-Island, their star pitcher Gregory Bruno, who threw a perfect game in the first and allowed only one run in the second, wasn't eligible to play this one by Little League rules. This table from Staten Island IS-51 are all friends and classmates of starting pitcher Chris Bedford, who they watched with sad faces as he gave up 6 runs.
When you see him up there, all that pressure, how's he handling all the pressure?
He's handling pretty good.
What advice would you give him?
To stay calm.
It's nerve-wracking enough just knowing the kids and watching the game. If it was one of my children up there doing it, I don't think I'd be able to watch.
The Doyle family just came back from Williamsport after seeing 2 victorious games, and they're still trying to figure out what went wrong with this one, but they are still so proud of their Staten Island team.
And there is still hope. Everyone's very excited watching Channel 11 here at O'Neill's, but there is still hope. Now, if they win tomorrow, they play Georgia tomorrow. If they win that game, then they play Hawaii again Saturday, and then they move on to the World Series. So let's hear one big cheer for Mid-Island. Let's hear 1, 2, 3.